It's almost time to say g'day to our old mates again, with the Trans-Tasman bubble in place from tomorrow. Kiwis and Aussies dusting off their passports and packing their bags today as the first flights get set to take off. Thousands are expected through our airports with different zones in place and the return of duty-free shopping. Our reporters are standing by with reaction from both sides of the Tasman. We begin with Jared McCulloch in Queenstown. And Jared, there's got to be a bit of a buzz there tonight.
Yes, definitely. A sense of excitement, anticipation and hope for our Trans-Tasman friends. This could be the saviour for many businesses that have been relying on visitors over this time, and it's hoped that the Australian visitors will add that much-needed boost. It'll be exactly 387 days since a commercial airline flight landed from Australia into Queenstown. And of course, there'll be other flights too coming into Auckland and Wellington tomorrow. But on the Trans-Tasman bubble eve, it was all about that last-minute prep to do. The welcome signs are out for our Aussie cousins at Wellington Airport, and the partitions are down in Auckland. Duty-free shopping's making a comeback.
This is a really big move for us. We're able to bring all of our staff back, working almost full-time hours, which is really great for them.
Her team's prepping for an influx. Other businesses also working hard.
We've had to strip everything out of the store, so it's been a long week getting stock back into the store, getting the store merchandise cleaned and up and ready for people to come back through.
There's excitement in Queenstown too. Sheila the Larroquette's the only Australian visitor this wildlife park seen in more than a year.
We're looking at somewhere around 40 or 50% of our visitors are generally Aussies, so we're really looking forward to having our friends from across the ditch back.
Australians account for 60% of the town's wedding industry, which is hoping for a bubble boost.
I think it's just going to bring a lot of joy, a lot of excitement for both couples here that'll have their families here to celebrate with them. Hopefully it means no more Zoom called speeches.
There's a buzz among Uber drivers in the capital, but caution too.
We are pretty secure and safe here at the moment, but people coming from Australia and I don't know.
Among the safeguards, a thermal camera at Wellington Airport to screen passenger temperatures and signs encouraging the use of the New Zealand Tracer app and Bluetooth. Auckland's international terminal will operate with red and green zones.
Manage isolation and quarantine customers, that side of the portal. Quarantine-free travel, our customers will never come this far.
This retailer says she's been told to expect thousands of passengers tomorrow.
To be honest, any kind of passenger walking through that is excited to travel in the quarantine bubble, we'll be happy to greet them.
It's just great to have hope again, a bit of optimism. It just feels like a bit of light at the end of the tunnel.
As we say goodbye to some restrictions and g'day to new beginnings. Jared McCulloch, One News.
Of course, there'll be many returning New Zealanders among the arrivals, most have been stuck because they couldn't afford to pay for quarantine. Andrew McFarlane with more.
Jason is packing his whole life into just a couple of boxes and suitcases.
There's a whole bunch of stuff that's actually already over there. It was shipped a few months ago. I've been living out of boxes.
He's been in limbo for 4 months, staying in temporary accommodation in Sydney. The wait for quarantine-free travel has been a long one.
Yeah, I missed out on my own birthday, Easter and Christmas with my family. And there's definitely been a price paid, by Kiwis living overseas.
Separation only made worse by online trolls.
Really hateful rhetoric, I think, for Kiwis that are just, that are just like every other Kiwi, just trying to come home.
Since October, New Zealanders have been able to travel to Australia quarantine-free. More than 22,000 people have made the trip, and now that it's a two-way agreement, many more are expected to return home. But for some, the cost of quarantine has been too much to bear.
And even now, I think it's a bit hard if something happens and the border's shut. Not everyone can be able to be stuck in another country, potentially, even if it's only a few days.
Marooned in Melbourne, Judy's looking forward to getting home to see her young niece and nephew.
It's crazy how long it's been to be able to not travel freely, and being able to do now is really amazing.
It's only a matter of hours until Jason boards his flight.
Mum and my sister are going to meet me at the airport. I'm really looking forward to that. I haven't seen them in a very, very long time, so it's going to be lots of big hugs.
As we rediscover a closer connection with our Trans-Tasman neighbours.
Love a good airport reunion, Andrew. How is tomorrow going to unfold?
Well, there are going to be plenty of those tomorrow morning, Melissa. But for travellers, the first thing they're going to notice, which maybe is a sign things aren't quite back to normal just yet, is one of these. Face masks are absolutely mandatory in New South Wales and many airports around Australia for travellers. So this will be coming on and only being taken off at the other side when people have left an airport in New Zealand. Now, currently there are no community outbreaks or reported community outbreaks, meaning no one needs to be getting a pre-departure test, which is good news. So people will be going about their trip as normal tomorrow on one of more than 20 flights bound for New Zealand. So they are going in strong at the very, very beginning. But you have to remember this is a two-way deal. There are people who are coming here to a very noisy airport in Australia. There are people who haven't been able to see their loved ones in New Zealand because of that cost of quarantine. So for many, this will be a very, very sweet reunion, possibly a chance to go on holiday with the comfort they'll be able to head home back to New Zealand without paying $3,000 for a spot in MIQ.
Ngā mihi nui. Thanks very much, Australia correspondent Andrew McFarlane.